I love democracy. I love the Republic.
The main thing is to protect these characters, make sure that they still continue to live in the way that you created them, and that the universe of Star Wars continues to grow.
So why did Parag Agrawal fire two top executives and announce more firings occurring at Twitter and more changes, hiring freeze, etc.? Friday morning, Elon Musk posted that the buying of Twitter for Tesla, the Tesla CEO, was on hold temporarily, depending on an investigation into fake accounts. Now, I've talked about this before, but fake accounts are plethora at Twitter. You can get an audit site to audit other people's accounts, and they can, and you can see who's got fake accounts. And it's kind of important to the basically financing of this deal and the price of the company. Now, stock prices have gone back to pre-Elon Musk buying levels because of this. But if Twitter subscriptions membership is not as big in reality as was first reported, he has every right to ask what's going on and can we find out just what this company is really worth before I spend $44 billion on it. So, Agrawal, that day, fires two executives, and announces a hiring freeze and more firings. Why? I have an idea on this. Agrawal wants this deal to go through. He wants us to be a happy-dappy, we hang out, we do stuff kind of deal. And I think he realized people were holding things from him. They were withholding information from him. Like I said, you can actually get a Twitter audit site if you have a Twitter membership. Audit your own followers to see if they're real or not. And audit, let's say like I want to audit Pablo Hidalgo's public site, public account, and I find half of his 8,000 of his 16,000 followers are fake. That's a big deal. That says A, his reach isn't as big as he purports it to be, and B, it says it makes you ask, how did he get this? Well, you can buy followers. You guys, if you've been on Twitter long enough, you know you'd see ads come out. You can buy Twitter followers, and they're just bots, okay? Elon Musk has probably done a lot of auditing, I would say. He could probably tell just by looking at an account if it's real or not. And you can also tell, like, take the Roe versus Wade thing. You can see if they're say if every account is saying the exact same thing, they're probably bots. Okay, this is a big deal. Again, it devalues the company. Okay, now I think Agrawal did this because he wants Musk to buy it. I honestly think that there are probably people at Twitter who don't like the fake stuff and don't really like the idea that Twitter's become a propaganda machine and a narrative creation machine, okay? And so what I think is, look, this is what happened. Early that day, Friday, Musk said the deal was on hold. 2 hours later, he came back and said he's still committed to buy Twitter. And a few hours later, Agrawal came on and said, the deal's going to go through. Okay. So these guys are committed to this. And if Elon Musk backs out, he owes $1 billion. Twitter backs out, they owe $1 billion. Okay. And really, it's gone too far now to back out without, you know, egg being on everybody's faces. So I do, it is probably going to go through, but I don't think that it's going to be for a $44 billion deal. I think it's probably going to be a little bit less. And the simple reason is, look, when they open up the algorithm, and this is before Musk takes over, there was shit going down. There were people that people hadn't seen in a long time showing back up, banned accounts coming back on. And also celebrities were losing thousands of accounts because they bought bots. They bought bots to inflate their social media reach. It's a good idea, okay? I would say, if you want your name out there, you need more followers, this is a cheap and easy way to do it, okay? But it deflates, in the end, the value of Twitter. Okay, this is why this is happening. And I fully expect the deal to go through, okay? Twitter is going to be a very different animal by the time this is all over. I expect Parag Agrawal to fire 1,000 people, just like Musk said he would do. But I think they're both on the same book or page. This is why this is happening. This is Steph signing out. I'll see you around the galaxy.